Male facelifts. You know, facial rejuvenation is a lot different in males than in females, because in males, you want to really retain a lot of their rugged look often, and of course their masculinity. And sometimes you can lose that, and it can really almost destroy their look, their career, their life. Look at Mickey Rourke, look at Kenny Rogers, you know, even Burt Reynolds. I mean, these are all famous actors that once they had and lost that rugged look, you know, those heavy eyebrows, you know, and even that look around their cheeks, they then look like different people. And some of that really affected their ability to act, because so many people have that look that people like. They like the look of a Kenny Rogers or the Burt Reynolds. But if you just windswept it, you just sweep it back and give them that windswept look and take out all their skin of their upper eyelids and their fat, they look weird. Remember, as plastic surgeons, we're in the face protection, not witness protection program. And that is devastating. And so much of that is from excess skin removal, not paying attention to the deep layers, and probably most importantly, not restoring fat where they need it. It's not about so much about pulling it as tight as you can. It's putting the tissue back in the right places that you know and can do. Remember, the anatomy hasn't changed, but what we have changed is our understanding of how we age. And when we understand the science of aging, we can restore it. We can make it look natural. We can make it look great. We can make it look like you, but a better you, a 20 years less old you. In other words, you want to look as good as you feel for your age. That's great plastic surgery. So, especially in males, the worst thing you can do is make them look too tight, too overdone. And it's bad for everybody, but in males, it's total distortion. You know, I would say in Kenny Rogers, too much skin was taken out and too much fat was taken out of his upper and lower eyelids, because one thing we've learned is that fat is precious. And if you take out too much fat in the upper and lower eyelid, it makes you look older. Isn't that unbelievable? Well, too much fat and skin was removed from his upper and lower eyelid. And also, his skin was, you know, pulled too tight. They didn't restore the fat in the central face. So he looks very windswept and drawn. And that looks terrible. So look like you want to be a better self of you 10, 15 years younger. You can't be younger than that, you know. We're plastic surgeons, we're not magicians, all right? Remember, and also we're not God. He's helping us, but we're not God. We can make you look better, make you look more like you, a younger you, and that's what you want. So enjoy, and find a true facelift expert, okay? Find a real board certified plastic surgeon. Find a real expert in facelift surgery, somebody who does it every day, and also understands the science of aging, so that every facelift's different. It's customizing the face, the analysis, and everybody's analysis and their face is different. So the operation has to be different. You can't do the same template on every face, or they'll look the same. And that's what's happened to these famous movie stars, okay? You've got to individualize the care and the facelifts for everybody. Okay, know before you go, come like and subscribe to all my great videos. And the latest and greatest are always on Mondays and Fridays at 9 a.m. We're coming on you on all the hot topics, both in cosmetic medicine, cosmetic surgery, and things that interest you that are very, very important for you to know before you go. Enjoy.